This is the fingerless whistle tutorial. To start with, I'm going to show you how to do a fingered whistle, because it's a lot easier to master the fingerless whistle if you already know how to do a fingered whistle. Alright, to start with, you want your fingers just like that, but you want them just touching, not too much. Then with your tongue, you want to relax it, just like that. And then, you want to rest this on your teeth and put it on your tongue just like this. And then after that, you want to seal your lips around your fingers. And then you want to blow the air down through this part right there, because that's a V-shape, and the V-shape creates the sound along with the bevel in the teeth and rubbing against the lips. So this is how you do the fingered one. Then once you've mastered that, you can do the fingerless one, where to start with, you have to get your lips and pull them over your bottom and top teeth, like that. And you want to extend your bottom jaw, and you want to pull, you only want like a centimeter gap, and you want it to pull your lips out towards your ears, like this. Then with your tongue, you want to make it flat on top, and you just want your tongue to be flat and relaxed, like this. And then once you got like that, you just pull it in, and you want just touching the top of your, the bottom, the back part of your lip that's pulled into your mouth, like this. Then after that, you should be able to blow it loud, really loud, but just try and blow it sort of, not really loud to start with, so you just get used to it like this. And then you go. And then up that, you can. Yeah, and that's pretty much how you do it. You can get it really loud like this. It's louder than the fingered one. And yep. And. There's really no more tips except maybe just change everything around a bit, just slightly, like putting your jaw to the side or changing where your lip is just to get. Just to see what works better for you, just to find the sweet spot. And the only warning is don't do it too much, you might get a bit lightheadedness, and if you do it too much, you might get windburn on your lips, and yeah, that hurts, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So if you've got any questions, just ask. I'll tell you some other websites you can find good listening stories too. Yeah, that's it. Alright, good luck.